Lisa McCormick here, and this is a video on how to tune your ukulele. Now, I know there's probably a million videos out there on how to tune your ukulele. I'm making this one because many of those videos actually, while they're perfectly full of good information, they skip some of the quirky things that can go wrong when you're trying to tune your ukulele. And I'm going to include those in this lesson so that if any of these things should happen to you while you're tuning, you'll know why and what's going on and how to fix it. So let's get started. First of all, your notes, you want to know what the notes want to be of the open strings. So you've got a G, a C, an E, and an A. There's two different kinds of, basically two different kinds of tuners. Ones that clip on to your instrument, and ones that, for instance, you might have as an app on your phone or your computer. So the difference between these two kinds of tuners is this. The clip-on ones are actually reading the note through the vibration of the wood of your instrument. And they are unaffected by other sounds in the room. They can only hear what you play on your instrument. If you're using something that is an app, it is using a microphone to hear what note you are playing. So if there's any other sounds in the room, that microphone's going to get confused. So if that's the kind of tuner you want to use, you want to make sure and do it in a very quiet place. Okay? I'm using right now a clip-on. This is a D'Addario clip-on tuner, which I like these in particular because they're so small that it can live on the instrument. I mean, you don't have to take it off. It fits right into the case and everything. It's harder to lose that way. When you first turn it on, you'll notice not only that when you play a string, you see a letter name appear on the screen, but you may also see a number. And the number should say 440. It's usually pretty tiny, but 440 is standard tuning for all musical instruments in our culture. So one thing that can go wrong for people is they don't realize they must have pushed some button and it's gone up to 443 or 447 or whatever. And you tune your instrument, your tuner says it's fine, but then when you try to play with someone else, it's like, it's in tune with itself, but it's not in tune with the rest of the world. So make sure you see the number 440, no more, no less, okay? What the tuner will tell you when you pluck a note is what the letter name of that note is, and if your string is a little bit too high, or if your string is a little bit too low. Think of a stretchy rubber band and going boing. If we pull it tighter, what happens to the boing? It gets higher. So tightening the string makes it higher. If we let that rubber band go slack and it goes bonk, it means the string is loose and the note is too low. So your tuner will indicate, usually depending on the style of it, it will have some way of indicating that your note is spot on. There might be a needle right in the middle of a dial. The light might turn green when it used to be red. All kinds of options like that. So let's take a look at this in context. I've got my little clip-on tuner on, and I'm going to play the G, and I'm getting a nice green, which means I'm in tune. I'm going to play the next string, the C, and I'm getting a nice green, that means I'm in tune. I'm going to play the next string, the E, I'm getting a nice green, means I'm in tune. I tuned before I made the video. Last string and A, and it's nice and green. So that's what we're aiming for. What if, however, one of these strings was out of tune? So I'm going to take my A string and just randomly give it a twist. So it's going to put it out of tune. Now, we don't know if it's too high or if it's going to be too low, but the tuner will tell us. Until it comes in on an A and turns green. So now this uke is in tune. This is another style of clip-on tuner. They tend to be bigger. They tend to need to be removed in order to put the uke back in its case. But on the positive side, they've got a much bigger screen, easier to read. But the thing with tuners like this that you want to watch for is if you click it's basically usually the on and off button. These tuners are designed for multiple stringed instruments, a number of different instruments. The one I just used before, you can use on any instrument. But these tuners are designed to kind of help you dial in your particular instrument. And the way that you will know what instrument your tuner thinks you are playing is that there will be a little tiny letter down here. And as I click this button, that letter changes. See how it pops all over the place? Okay. So my choices are, as I click that, and I see a G. It might think I'm tuning a guitar. Next one, I see a B. It might think I'm tuning a bass. Next thing I see is a V. It might think I'm tuning a violin. And the next thing I see is a U with a little C next to it. That's what we're looking for this to be tuning the ukulele in C tuning. Other than that, once I've got the proper instrument dialed in on my tuner, it's going to work just the same way. It's going to show me when I've got the notes right on. So I'm getting a nice bright green G, so it likes that. Let's try the C. Try the E. It likes that. And the A, it likes that. It turns green. And the same thing if one of these were to go out of tune. So let's say I put my E string out of tune on purpose. Now let's see what the tuner has to say about that. Oh, it says I have an E, but you can see that the arrow is way over to this edge, which means it's E-ish, but it's way too low. It's too loose. So I'm going to tune up very slowly, turning that knob, watching that needle come towards the middle, until I get a green, and I'm in tune. So I started this video with also talking about things that can go wrong when you're tuning. And here is one of the most common things I've seen go wrong with my beginner students. And that is that the tuner is really good at reading reading the note through the wood of your instrument. But what it doesn't know is what note you are looking for. So if you feed it a G that's a good G in tune, a G that's a little too high, a G that's a little too low, you had to know that the note you're looking for is G. The tuner doesn't know that. The tuner will tell you whatever note you've got is spot on in tune once it turns green. But it could be that you've got an F, which isn't one of the notes we're looking for. Maybe somebody came along and gave your knobs a twisty and you didn't realize it. And so you'll be tuning and tuning and you're tuning, and it says, well, it says I'm in tune. The thing is green. And I'd say, well, look at what letter name is on the tuner. And it says F. Well, F isn't one of the notes we're looking for. So if you end up getting a note in tune that is not one of the notes we're looking for, you have to figure out how to, what's the relationship between the note you did tune in and the one you are looking for. So let's say I picked up my ukulele and somebody had been playing with the knobs, and I go to tune it and I play this first note, and look what it says. It says F. Oh, okay, well, I'm not paying attention to the fact that it says F. I'm paying attention to how nice and green that F is. Right? This is my mistake. My tuner doesn't know that it should be a G. It likes any note. It'll tell you any note is in tune when it is. But now that I have an incorrect note in the mix, look what I've got when I play. I've got this weird note, but it says it's in tune. So double check and make sure it's in tune with the note that you want it to be. So this F is too low. F is below G in the alphabet. So we need to go up and up and up and up until I get. There we go. So now it is a G, which it should be. But the tuner didn't know that. I have to know that, and you have to know that. I hope you enjoyed this rather exhaustive video about tuning your ukulele, but I wanted to keep you out of some of the trouble spots that people get sunk into that just end up being tremendously frustrating. My name is Lisa McCormick, professional ukulele instructor. Please visit my website at lisamccormick.com, and happy playing.